So you worked ridiculously hard color grading your photo, trying to get the best look, and spent hours and hours just to get something which is pleasing to your eyes. Have a look at this. Here we have an image, interesting one, and we begin to add filters. I've done this before, and we start to add adjustments here. Adjustment after adjustment, just trying to get something which is amazing, something which is awesome. So we begin to add them. And at the end, I'm satisfied with the result. Have a look at this. So here is the before. Here is the after. We might have to decrease the opacity a little bit, but here's the thing. Suppose you like this style and you want to apply it to other images as well. What do we do? There are three ways to do it. As you can see, it's very complex, right? So it's not just one adjustment that we save it as a preset. No, it's complex. A lot of adjustments have been added. So there are three ways to do it. Number one, simple one, save this as a PSD. So if you save this as a PSD, and then whenever you want to apply it to other images, just open the other image, copy all those layers and paste them. I think it's kind of dumb, but let me show you how to do that. Okay, so all we need to do, select the last adjustment, hold the Shift key, select the top adjustment, Control or Command G. Now you have a group of them. All we need to do, press Control or Command C when the group is selected. Let's go to another document and then press Control or Command V. Have a look at this. It has been applied. Of course, we would decrease the opacity just a little bit, something like this. Looks great. So that's one way of doing this. But the problem is every time you have to open that PSD, which is going to be huge. Instead of doing that, the second way is saving it as a lookup table. All right. So we are actually waiting for the third way, which is really awesome. But I want to keep the options open. You choose what fits best for you. All right. So we don't want to save it. Let's get back to this. The second way is let's ungroup it, right click on it and choose ungroup layers. Make sure you have a locked background layer at the bottom and nothing else except for adjustments. And then we would go to File, Export, and then Color Lookup Table, right? And description, I'm going to leave it at that. Make sure you're in medium, low quality. We don't want low quality. High quality makes it huge. We don't want that as well. So let's keep it at medium, and 3DL works with Photoshop. Just uncheck others. You don't need a bunch of files over there. Hit OK. And we're going to save it in this folder called tutorial, and example PiXimperfect is OK. And let's just save it. So it's saving. It's saved. Now let's open that document up, which we opened up previously. I think it was sample PiXimperfect. All right. Now all we need to do, we need to add a color lookup adjustment. Click on the adjustment layer icon right there and choose color lookup. And inside of that, we will click on a load 3D LUT and we will load that in the tutorial folder. This one was the one. Hit open and you have the same thing. Have a look. So you can reduce the opacity a little bit. Let's go 50%. We are good. That was the second way. And the third way is really awesome. And the third way is something which this tutorial was all about. And that is something which I learned from Pratik Nayak. You might have heard about him. He is world class, awesome retoucher. And he taught me this really awesome technique. Keep in mind, this only works if you have Photoshop CC and you are a Creative Cloud member. So all we need to do in this case, make a group again. So select the curves, hold the Shift key, select the top one, Control or Command G. Name it properly. I'm going to name it. Let's name it Royal Blue. Isn't that a good name? Now go to Windows and then Libraries. Okay, make sure you're signed in into Creative Cloud and then open up the graphics. Drag the group and drop it over there. Now it uploads that to the cloud. It's uploading as you can see right now. There you have Royal Blue. Now, before you turn off this tutorial, there's some extra steps as well. You cannot just drag and drop it. So let's delete this group right here. Now, if you drag the Royal Blue from the libraries and drop it over there, it's just going to open a smart object, which isn't going to make any sense to you. Hit enter or return. No sense. It's the same thing, right? But however, have a look. If you double click on the thumbnail, it opens up another document with all the adjustments. So what does that tell you? It is still there. It is still there. We just have to open it in a different way. So instead of doing that, all we have to do, right click on it and choose place layers. Now you have the layers. Isn't that awesome? Alternatively, we can do this much more quickly by just holding one key, and that key is option. So if you hold the option key, drag it and drop it over there, it just places the layers. Amazing. Now, the great thing about this feature is this. Anywhere you are in the world, if you have a computer and an internet connection, you're pretty much good to go. All you have to do, just sign into Photoshop with your Creative Cloud account and then just open up libraries and it will be there. So, if you have Photoshop CC, method number 3 is for you. If you have older versions of Photoshop, method number 1 or 2 are the best things that you can do. I truly hope this video helped you, and if it did, make sure to give us a like, and also don't forget to subscribe, and not just subscribe. Ring the bell so that you, my friend, don't miss any other future tip, trick or tutorial. Talking about future tutorials, I have an awesome tutorial coming up about color grading. Complex, amazing color grading in minutes. It's gonna be totally awesome, so stay tuned for that. I'll see you guys in my next one. Till then, stay tuned and make sure that you keep creating. I shouldn't have said stay tuned twice, but that's okay, I'm just used to it.